Hello, Deployment Insiders. Welcome to Building 36 here at the Microsoft headquarters in Redmond, Washington. Each week, we're going to be delivering best practices, tips, and tricks for you to better deploy and manage your Office 365 ProPlus clients. My name is Amesh Munsakani, and today we're going to be talking about the best options for upgrading to Office 365 ProPlus. So let's get started. Let's get right to it, right? So what we have here is the Office customization tool for Click to Run. What you're gonna see is a new site. If you haven't been to the site most recently, you can actually get it through config.office.com. Now we have a couple of different things that you're gonna have to look at here. One is you have the ability to go sign in, so you need Azure Active Directory account if you wanna dive in. These are for more advanced features, but for today's session, let's talk about these two things at the bottom. I can take and create a brand new configuration, or I can go ahead and import an existing configuration file if you have one and be able to visually see this. Previously in the past, you'd look at, you know, this XML file. Now the XML file was a great way to really highly customize your deployment. Unfortunately, I'm not a big fan of XML because I tend to just mess this up. So what we came up with is a great way for you to be able to visually see and build this configuration file in order to successfully do your deployments. So now all I gotta do is click on the create and it takes me to this particular page right here. Now this is my XML builder in the Office customization tool. This thing manages a lot and tons of different types of configurations. With today's conversation, we're just gonna be focusing on upgrades and what are the things that I need to be able to do within this tool in order to be able to get you to the right set of configurations. So what you're gonna see here is a number of sections, anywhere from selecting my products to the type of languages and installation and so forth. So we'll be walking down through this entire list and showing you what are the right things to be able to do for upgrades. And on the right-hand side, is the actual outcome of those configurations and settings that you're actually defining here. Now, the first thing you're gonna wanna do is determine where do you wanna go? Do you want a 32-bit installation or 64-bit installation? And we've defaulted to 64-bit because we've been seeing that a lot of companies are now moving to 64-bit due to things like Excel and better memory management. Now, things that you have to consider here are if you are moving to 64, any of the add-ins that you have will also need to be 64-bit compatible. So you're gonna have to check that with your manufacturer, your third-party ISV, in order to get that information. But if you do, fantastic, let's get you to 64-bit. You'll get a lot more performance, a better reliability on your product, and so I think you'll be in good shape there. Now, the first thing we're gonna do is select the Office suite that we wanna do. You can see we have multiple different products here. We have some of our perpetual bits, but for this video, we're gonna select Office 365 ProPlus. You can see all the different individual applications that are available here. I have Access, I have OneDrive Desktop, Outlook, Publisher, and so on. So here I can choose to actually not have those available and exclude them directly from here. For example, most organizations that I know don't want Access to be on every single desktop. Same thing for Publisher. And so I'm gonna leave the OneDrive desktop, a fantastic application for me to save my files in the cloud. We obviously have Outlook, we have Excel, Skype for Business, PowerPoint, and Word. All of those I want to have on my desktop. Now the next thing I wanna do is understand what is my source. Now this is great, especially if you're downloading and installing directly from the CDN, but otherwise, this might not be as relevant if you're just gonna be downloading the bits and deploying it from a local source, whether it's configuration manager or it's a file share. We would still want to determine what that looks like here just for more of a sanity check. But if you are downloading from directly from the internet, we would select that particular channel. So I'm gonna go with semi-annual channel for this one. Once I have that done, it's all about languages now. And so there's some tips here that I want you to be able to understand on what most organizations do to help reduce the size of your overall package. Now let's consider what this looks like. An Office package, if you're downloading it, directly and going to be distributing from a local file share. You're going to have 800 megs as your core set of files, and then every language pack is going to be about 200 megs. Now let's say your organization has somewhere around anywhere 8 to 10 languages. You're gonna be adding approximately another, let's say 2 gigs to every endpoint. That becomes pretty tough to do. So we came up with a simple tip that I think was gonna help you a lot. Let's pick a common language, let's say English US for everybody out there. And what we can do next is when I select an additional language, I could say match the operating system. I'm gonna click on update here. And now what this does is, it says if I'm going to go ahead and download that, I'm only gonna download my core files, and then it's going to detect what additional languages that I actually have and need by individual PCs. It's gonna look at the OS version and all the languages that are available on that particular OS build and say if I have French, Spanish, and German on that, I'm gonna go and then request for French, Spanish, and German. Now, you're gonna ask me next, well, if I'm not downloading all those bits, where am I gonna get that from? Ah, I have a great answer for that. What we built out here is the ability to say, hey, go ahead and get it from iLocal source. So I'm gonna just say server one and OPP. That's where I'm gonna go get it from. And then I have this fallback to CDN for missing languages. And what this does now, it goes ahead and gets all my languages directly for the CDN. So now you're reducing the amount of source files that you have on your individual network, and then every other language that you require, we'll get it directly from CDN. And it also gives you the option to do a lot more. Office today has about 105 languages, some full languages, majority, some partial languages, but your core full set of languages, we have about 40 today. And the reality is you can also get the list directly from here by filtering whether I want my full or partial languages. So that's available right there. Moving on from here, we're gonna go ahead and talk about how we wanna deal with updates as well as some upgrades. Now, what you wanna do is set how Office is then going to be serviced. And what do I mean by that? What I'm saying is every month we still deliver a version of Office that has the latest security patches as well as any bug fixes based on the channel that you're at. And so you wanna define whether I'm gonna get those directly from my CDN or do I wanna get on a local source? Now we recommend that you go to the CDN because one, you'll get the smallest download possible. We use a concept called the binary delta compression where we download just what is needed to service and update that particular version of Office. Now that's gonna reduce the amount of download size that you're gonna need in order to service that particular version of Word.exe. So moving on, the next thing that we also have is, since now we are talking about upgrades, we wanna say, how do we treat an old version of Office? Now, if we have an existing version of a perpetual MSI bits, we have the option to automatically have you uninstall MSI by just very one click. I can turn it off if I don't need to, if this is gonna happen to be a clean install, or if you want a side-by-side situation, meaning if you wanna have Word 2010 along side-by-side with Word ProPlus, which I would not recommend, but you know, we definitely have that option for those of you who truly, truly need it. In this case, I would suggest turning it on, where we can go ahead and remove and uninstall. So no scripts that you have to have out there, no prepping your box beforehand. This option takes care of it. But if you do have any Visio projects or SharePoint Designer that you need to leave behind, we can certainly do so. But in this case, I'm gonna say just keep all these on for this option. The next thing you're gonna want to do here is look at your licensing and activation. We have the option to do automatically accept the end user license agreement on behalf of the user. So if you don't want them to see it, you can turn it on, and then of course you will get a copy and see what that looks like. And then the next thing is shared computer activation. This is really important if you are deploying Office to a shared computer device, which means that I have two people signing in with their own user credentials. If it's a kiosk situation, where user A comes in, they sign in, they get to use Office and their customizations, and then user B would come in and do their own thing from there. I wouldn't recommend it to install it on every single one of your device because it increases the amount of network chatter to our services to ensure that you guys have, you know, the right set of activations going. Your license length is much lower. So if you have a lot of devices where you have the laptop or desktop and a single user using it, I would just turn this off and move on to the next section. And we are almost done with this thing. And as you can see right on the right-hand side, every single thing that I've been clicking on and configuring, it shows me in a nice little pane and shows me exactly what I've been selecting so I can double check and ensure that's the right thing for me. Now, right before we wrap up here, we have our general settings. If I want to put a company name, so in this case, Contoso Corporation, and I can type in any description. This is more for personal notes, right? So I could say baseline image for Contoso. Click on next. This is a new capability that we recently released, which is the application preferences. This gives you the option to configure basic preferences at install time. If you're used to the OCT for MSI, this is the exact same thing. You can go ahead and configure any of your applications or general office settings directly from here, and the user can go ahead and change it later on. For example, if I look at hide, learn more about SharePoint hyperlinks, I can go ahead and click on this. I can say, go ahead and configure it for true, and that's it. Go ahead and close it, and now we know it's configured. Again, I get to scroll down here, and you can see what Office applications are configured here. That's it. Now we have a baseline image. Again, my recommendation is go ahead and configure a single baseline configuration file, and then after that, if you have specialty files, I would go ahead and configure additional ones and target it specifically to those users and devices. Once we're done there, we're gonna go ahead and export this. I'm gonna accept the EULA, which is basically terms of how you can use the configuration file. I can name the configuration file. I'm gonna leave it to what it is and go ahead and export that. If I open it, that is exactly the set of configurations that I've gone ahead and determined is going to be imported for my deployments. And that's it. And so now when you're ready to go ahead and deploy, you can use the Office deployment tool. Again, I have a link down below as to where you can get that. And you can go ahead and execute this file directly against it. You can use System Center Configuration Manager, or you can use other methods to deploy it to those end users and start your deployments from there. And it's going to be able to make sure that you've excluded Groove, OneNote, Access, Publisher, and so on. And everything that we've configured will be just like this. Now, there's another upgrade scenario that we get a lot of questions on. Let's say you are already on Office 365 Pro Plus. How do I just simply move from a 32-bit to a 64-bit version of Office without going ahead and identifying what's on that box and recreating this XML file? Well, we're currently working on the ability for you to just set a simple flag on your deployment so we can go ahead and uninstall your 32-bit. We're gonna look at what you've configured, what applications there, all your cache kind of data, whether it's from Outlook or OneDrive for Business, and then simply lay down the 64-bit without you doing any additional work. I hope this was enjoyable for you and this gave you the right set of information. I'd love to hear more from you as to what information you'd like to make your deployments much easier. Until then, keep on deploying.